Arab traders visited in Malabar coast of India by the sea by spies and outer coming of the South Indian to sell them in overseas market. Apart from the maritime trade, the Arabs carried on their trade by land resources. With the rise of Islam in the first half of the 17th century, Arabia and other Western Asian countries were united together into a powerful political force under the banner of Islam. After the death of Muhammad, Islamic empire came into existence under the leadership of the Caliph, the successor of Prophet Muhammad. With the appearance of Islam, the Arab traders who had trade connection with India propagated their new faith in this country, and some of the people embraced the new religion. Many of the Arab traders also settled down in Kerala and came to be known as the Muslims. In this way, the Muslim religion started. Stories about the fabulous wealth of India were carried back home by the Arab traders. Naturally, the prosperity of India was a source of great temptation for the newly Muslim empire. Filled with the zeal of spreading their religion, together with the temptation of collecting wealth from India, the Arabs under Muhammad bin Qasim invaded Sindh in 712 AD. Though King Dahir of Sindh put up a heroic resistance, he was defeated and put to death. Marching forward, Muhammad bin Qasim conquered the whole of Sindh, including Multan, but his conquest was short-lived as he was soon recalled by the Caliph. The Arab Muslim who had come with Qasim continued to rule in Sindh, and their rule extended through their descendants about 300 years. However, they were unable to extend their kingdom to any other part of India because of the strong opposition of the Rajputs, who ruled northern India from 8th to 12th century AD. The Arab invasion of India proved a failure from political point of view. Arab administration of Sindh started. Muhammad bin Qasim divided the conquered province into a number of districts, which were handed over to the Arab officer against the rendering military service. Ordinary soldiers, Muslim saints, and scholars revived grants of land. Thus, a number of Arab military colonies sprang up, where in course of time, a population of mixed Arab and Indian came into existence. Towards Hindu, they adopted a policy of political toleration. Only jizya tax was taken from the Hindus. The chief source of income was the land tax and jizya tax. The collection of revenue was placed in the hands of the local Hindus. The Brahmins did not protect the entrusted high officer in judicial field. The Hindus did not get their justice. At that time, according to principles of the Quran, which resulted in the great injustice to the Hindus, it was a very memorable insistence. They tortured the Hindus. The world Muhammad bin Qasim administered displayed a good deal of moderation and worldly wisdom. So what is the effects of Arab conquest? Why the Arabs have come to India and affected? What type of effects were established? It has been remarked that the Arab conquest of Sindh was an episode in the history of India and Islam. From political point of view, this remark is true. They were unable to extend their kingdom to any other part of India because the neighboring Rajputs were too strong for them. So they remained cut off them. Rest of India and the interior politics of country remained quiet and unaffected in their influence. Number two, the Arabs were Muslim in their faith, and as a result of their conquest of Sindh, they won some following for their faith, and the Arab conquest of Sindh led to the spread of Islam. Number three, in the cultural field, the Indian good deal of the Arab masters. The Arab learned something of Indian astronomy. The Indian system, medicine, and carried their newly knowledge to the Arabia. Whence it spread to the emperor. It was they who introduced into Europe the Indian numerals under the name of Arabic. Number four, Indian philosophy influenced the mysticism of the Sufis. Number five, the Caliph of Baghdad welcomed Indian scholar and physician and utilized their service in getting many Sanskrit books translated into Arabic. What are the causes of the failure of Arabs? The failure of Arabs was due to resistance of Rajput. Number one. Number two, the enterprise was too feebly supported by the college to spread further. It was an entry from wrong quarter. The province of Sin, consisting chiefly of desert, was too unnumerative, so the caliph politically abandoned it. Number four, not supported by the home government. Number five, the Arab Sins were too few in number, quite inadequate and insufficient to achieve such formidable and difficult tasks as the conquest of India. Sindh remained province of the empire for a little over century and half, but as a power declined, the Muslim governor of Sindh virtually became the independent. The province was abandoned by the caliph and Sindh became a prey to discord the disunion. It was into the independent kingdoms of Multan and other states. In this way, coming to the Muslim establishment of Delhi started. And then Muhammad of Ghazni, born in 971 AD, Muhammad was the eldest son of Shamsuddin, the ruler of Ghazni. His first important invasion was against the Hindu Shahi kingdom and other hesitating Jayapala, who had been defeated by his father. Twice was collecting Hindu king with his son and grandson. In 1600 AD, the Mohammed led an expedition against Multan, which after 7 days, he Mohammed gave a charge of Multan to Sukhopala, the Nawab of Shah, the grandson of Jayapala. In this way, step by step, in 1900 AD, Mohammed led a successful expedition to Nagarkot, known for his legacy, wealth, and return to Ghazni with the riches and jewels which far extended to the treasury of the mightiest king of the world. Between 1009 and 1018, Muhammad's four expeditions satisfied a thirst for riches in the riches of the of India. In words of Ishwari Prasad, the acquisition of treasury, the capacity of Muhammad Khalar, and a repeated the red win of the remarkable frequency. In 1019 AD, Muhammad led an expedition against Rajapala, Prithvirajapala, and Kaunoja, who submitted with resistance. The Sultan is said to have plundered as many as 10,000 temples and after collecting huge booty, returned to Ghazni. At that time, the most important invasion of Muhammad was the invasion of Somanatha temple in 1028-25 AD. It is said that temple of Somanatha was endowed with more than 10,000 village for its upkeeper, and yet the most precious gift is that the part of the country, the temple bells were hung with massive chains of gold, and more 2,000 monks, Muhammad marched 1,100 kilometers across the edges of Sindh and Rajasthan to reach the temple of Somanath in Kathiwada, situated on the seashore in the modern Gujarat state. In 1024 AD, he started from Ghazni with a big force of 1,800 and reached Multan on 20th November. At that time, the Muslim forces reached in January 1025 AD, but its ruler, Bhimadeva, fled the safety. More than 50,000 people were slain and huge booty fell into the hands of the invader. His last invasion was against the Jats of Sin, who had tried to deprive him of some of his booty from Somanatha on his way back to Ghazni. He attacked them in 1026-27 AD and put many of them to death. Then the chief aim of the Jats. Muhammad made as many as 17 invasions of India. Historians hold different views regarding the main aim in making recurring invasion. Some historians believe that his main aim was to cross idolatry and spread Islam in India, but not borne by facts. It is in words of Habib, Islam neither convinced nor plundering motive of the invader. Secondly, he harassed the rightly said Muhammad would have begged with a little plunders to Somnath Mandir. Some others hold that Muhammad wanted to establish an empire. This aim also does not hold good because despite his 17 successful invasion, he did not annex any of the conquered territories except Punjab and part of Multan and Sindh. Most historians hold that the sole aim of Muhammad's invasion was to plunder the legendary wealth of India. According to Professor Dr. Ishwari Prasad, said that all the Muhammad wanted was the vast wealth which India was possessed, and when this was obtained, he returned to Ghazni and ultimately of annexation of permanent conquest. So what was the result of Muhammad's invasion to India? Though Muhammad was primarily concerned with plundering the enormous wealth of India, his recurring invasion had far-reaching results. Firstly, his successful recurring raids exposed the weakness of the Rajputs. Secondly, his feats threw open the northwestern gateway of India to his co-religions. Thirdly, his recurring invasion led to political instability, which in turn affected the prosperity of India. Fourthly, from Muhammad's main aim was to not to spread of the Islam in India, yet implanted to seed of the Islam in India. In this way, the great institution and art of architecture since ancient India gave a death blow to art architecture of the country. And then Muhammad Ghori, the successor of Muhammad Ghori, could not keep the kingdom instant. In 1135, Muhammad Ghori occupied the kingdom of Ghazni. He too had an uncontrollable, ambitious benefit from the prosperity of India and extended his kingdom to the Indo-Gangetic regions of this country. Muhammad Ghori raided India first in 1175 AD and defeated the Muslim ruler of Multan, whose territory was annexed to the Ghori kingdom. Thereafter, he occupied Ucho and another stronghold northwestern India. Encouraged by this conquest, he marched against modern Gujarat, but he was defeated by Raja Bhimadeva, the gallant Rajput ruler. Muhammad Ghori now realized that he needed to create a base in Punjab and embarked upon the conquest of India. In this way, having conquered the Punjab, Muhammad Ghori launched a series into territories of the Rajput rulers of northern India, who were known for their valor. Prithviraj Chauhan of Delhi and Ajmer and Joychandra Kaunoj and Banaras were two most powerful Rajput rulers of northern India at that time settled. In this way, the Battle of Torani, the causes of success achieved one by one. I will cover the Muslim rule in India. Now we start the administrative system of the Sultanate period. This is the next unit. Okay. Administrative system of Delhi. Discuss the main principles of administration in Delhi Sultanate. Number one question. Number two question. Give an account of the administration of Delhi Sultanate. Okay. Number three question. What was your opinion was the true nature of the government of Sultan of Delhi and their treatment of the subject population? Number four, what steps were taken by the Sultan of Delhi to improve the system of revenue administration? How far did they succeed in their efforts? In this way, which things responsible for the main principles of the administration system of Delhi? The principles of administration. The first step, principles of administration. The administration of the rulers of Delhi Sultanate was based upon certain principles. The Turks were the foreigners. They came to India for propagation of their religion. They had their certain principles on which they based their administration. Here we are discussing the principle. First, state based upon religion. First thing, the state based upon religion. Number one point. Okay, note out this. The Sultan of Delhi was not a secular state. It was theocratic. Islam was the religion of the state. The basis of Muslim state was never discarded by the rulers of Sultanate. This state was governed by the law of Shariat and Quran. The Muslim ulema had a great say in the administration. They were fanatical and biased. Every ruler had to obey the Quranic law. All the difficulties, problems were solved according to the direction of Quran. This idea of the Islamic State in India was to convert the people of this country to Muslim religion. Those who were ready to embrace Islam were given all sorts of facilities, and those who were not the followers of Islam were not favored by the rulers. This is number one cause. Number two, stress on devotion towards God and Khalifa. Stress on devotion towards God and Khalifa. During the reign of sultans, there was a great stress on the devotion towards God. The Muslims were against the idol worship, but they had great faith in Allah. In Quran, it is written that Allah is the ruler of the whole universe. To obey him is the greatest religion. Muhammad Shah was the last ruler of Allah and obey the order and duty of a Muslim. After the Pagamber comes Khalifa. Sultan is the representative of Khalifa, and so he could also obey. Okay. And then the number three point, that was stress on the duties of Sultan. What are the duties of the Sultan? Okay. बड़ बड़ अक्षर लिखी तातले कर दियो. इन इस्लामिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द ग्रेटेस्ट स्ट्रेस वाज गिवन टू द ड्यूटीज ऑफ सुल्तान. सुल्तान ऑलमोस्ट मस्ट रूल फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ देयर सब्जेक्ट्स. द रूल शुड बी बेस्ड अपॉन रिलीजन, अदरवाइज दे विल बी पनिश्ड बाय अल्लाह. अकॉर्डिंग टू मुस्लिम लॉ, इफ खलीफा और सुल्तान डज नॉट परफॉर्म हिज ड्यूटी टूवर्ड सब्जेक्ट्स एंड रिलीजन, द सब्जेक्ट्स हैव एवरी राइट टू रिमूव हिम. And number four, importance of ulemas. Ulemas were regarded as the commentators of religion, and so they had a great reputation. They were the guardians in the sacred law. Number five, one ruler for every Muslim society. In theory, there should be only one ruler for one Muslim society. Just as Allah is the one, in the same way, the ruler should be one. Khalifa was regarded as the real ruler in the Islamic theory. It has been propounded that Khalifa is the Muslim king of all Muslims wherever they might be living. Okay, and then the right of the society on the income of state. Number six, the right of society on the income of state. The right of society on the income of state. In the Islamic law, the income of the state was not the income of the rulers, but was for the benefit of the whole society. Every individual has the right to take maximum advantage from that income. The income of the state was always in the hands of the rulers. They spent this money according to their own will. Some of the rulers were extravagant and luxurious. They did not care for the Islamic theory that the society has the right upon the income of the state. Then number seven. Okay. The election system. According to Islamic theory of sovereignty, there should be the election of Imam. Every individual has the right to vote in his election. However, all these principles were not obeyed by the rulers of the Sultan's period. It is true that the state was theocratic, but the principles of one ruler for one society was not obeyed. The early rulers of Sultans of Delhi styled themselves in Khalifa, deputy of assistants, and received investiture from him. His name was inscribed on the coins of Khutba, was written in his name. The first ruler who did not practice this was Alauddin Khilij. His son Qutbuddin Mubarak himself took the title of Khalifa. Apart from these two rulers, almost all the rulers of Sultanate period recognized the nominal sovereignty of Khalifa for the sake of the Islamic unity, but Khalifa had no real powers. The election system also vanished in due course. The Sultan of Delhi started choosing their heirs, and the subject had to regard them as sultans. In this way, we find that by and by the Islamic theory of sovereignty was changed during the Sultanate period. But still, this cannot be denied that the place of Delhi Sultanate was built up Islamic principles. Hella? एंड देन द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, ଏଇଟା ବୋଲେ ଆମର କ'ଣ ପ୍ରୋଭିନ୍ସିଆଲ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ସୁଲତାନେଟ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍। ତ ଟିକେ ଶୁଣ କି କେମିତି ହେଉଛି ତାଙ୍କର ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟଟା ଥିଲା, ହେଲା ହ୍ୱାଟ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଆଟ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱାଟ ୱାଜ୍ ଦ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ ଇସଲାମିକ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍। ଦ ସୁଲତାନ, ସୁଲତାନ ୱାଜ୍ ଏ ଡେସ୍ପଟ୍। ଦ ହେଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦିଲ୍ଲୀ ସୁଲତାନେଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ସୁଲତାନ। ହି ୱାଜ୍ ଦି ସୋର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଅଲ୍ ପାୱାର୍ସ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଅଥରିଟି। ଦୋ ଦ ପ୍ରିନ୍ସିପଲ୍ ହି ହାଡ୍ ଟୁ ରୁଲ୍ ଏକର୍ଡିଂ ଟୁ ଦ କରାନ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ହାଡ୍ ଟୁ ରେକଗ୍ନାଇଜ୍ ଦ ଅଥରିଟି ଅଫ୍ ଖଲିଫା, ବଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟାଇସ୍ ହି ହାଡ୍ ଦ ସୁପ୍ରିମ୍ ପାୱାର୍ସ। ହି ୱାଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଦ ସଭରେନ୍ଟି ହେଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ କମାଣ୍ଡର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଆର୍ମି, ବଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଦି ମେକର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଲ। ଇନ୍ ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟାଇସ୍ ହି କୁଡ୍ ଡିଫାଏ ଦ ଅଥରିଟି ଅଫ୍ ଉଲେମା। ହିଜ୍ ପାୱାର୍ସ ୱାର୍ ୱାଇଡ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଡ୍। According to Dr. A.L. Srivastava has rightly remarked, he was a perfect autocrat and his authority was unfettered. And then number two, Sultan was a law unto himself. In Islamic theory, it had been propounded that Allah is the true king of Muslim state and Sultan is his agent. The dolt of Sultan had to enforce the so-called divine law as expressed in Quran. Thus, in practice, Sultan had all the judicial power to enforce and interpret law was his work. In his connection, he had to supreme power. Alauddin Khilij openly declared to prevent rebellion in which thousands perish, I issue such order as I conceive to be connective to be for the good for the state and the benefit of the people. I do not know whether this is lawful or unlawful. Whatever I think to be for the good or for the state suitable for the emergency, that I decree, and so far what may happen to me on the approaching day of judgment, that I not know. Okay, and then the third number point, Sultan was executive head of the administration. Hello? ବୁଝିପାରୁଛୁ? ଯୋଉଠି ନ ବୁଝିପାରିବ ଆମେ ଲାଷ୍ଟ ଅଧ ଘଣ୍ଟାରେ ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ କରିବା, ଆଉ ଯଦି ବି ଚାହୁଁଛ ଏବେ କିଛି କ୍ଲିଅର୍ ହେବା ପାଇଁ ତାହେଲେ କୁହ। ମୁଁ ହଉଛି ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ସୁଲତାନେଟ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ପଢ଼ଉଛି। ଉଷା, ହ୍ୟାଲୋ।
यस मैम
ହଁ, ଏନି ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ?
मैम पेज नंबर कंफ्यूजन हो रहा था।
ओ ये बुक का?
यस मैम
बुक का? और
यस
बुक
मैम
देख रही हो? मैं बुक से नहीं पढ़ा रहा हूँ, उस पॉइंट्स सब
ओह
नोट
ओके
करके नोट करके पढ़ा रही हूँ, इजी करके। थोड़ा उसमें थोड़ा क्या क्या डाल दिया है तो थोड़ा मिक्स कर दिया है, इधर का उधर, उधर का इधर कर दिया है, तो थोड़ा
ओके
मुझे
मैम
कंफ्यूज हुआ। ठीक है,
ठीक है मैम। यस मैम यस
ओके।
मैम
अगर तुम तो मेरा व्हाट्सएप में हो, अगर बाद में हो सके तो हम सबको ये व्हाट्सएप PDF करके छोड़ दूंगे। ठीक है,
यस मैम यस मैम
ओके ओके। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सुल्तान वाज द एग्जीक्यूटिव हेड ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। सुल्तान वाज नॉट ओनली द फाउंटेन ऑफ जस्टिस बट वाज ऑल्सो द एग्जीक्यूटिव हेड। ही हैड द राइट टू अपॉइंट और डिसमिस एनी ऑफिसर। हिज एग्जीक्यूटिव पावर्स वर ऑल्सो वेरी वाइड। इन मिलिट्री अफेयर्स ऑल्सो ही हैड द फाइनल से। ही वाज द कमांडर ऑफ द आर्मी एंड ऑल द मिलिट्री पावर्स वर कनेक्टेड इन हिज हैंड्स। एंड द नंबर फोर स्टेप, मोनार्ची वाज नॉट हेरिडिटरी। In the choice of Sultan, the principles of hereditary succession was not always obeyed. The king had the right to appoint his successor, but it was not always accepted. Iltutmish at that time of his death nominated Rezia as his successor, but nobles after his death raised his son Rukuddin on the throne and the king against the wishes of Bourbon. In fact, during the Sultanate period, nobles had to final word in choice of the king, and there was no fixed law of the succession during those days. Then Sultan's rule was military rule. The rulers of Delhi Sultanate based their rule upon the military power. Military power was very much necessary for the Sultan's period. Only with the help of military, they could not maintain peace and order in the country. Without the military force, they could not have been able to rule over this great country. In fact, there was no law during the Sultanate period. The theory and the practice were quite different. We can rightly say that during those days, might was right, not the right was might. Dr. A.C. Banerjee has rightly remarked, it is altogether impossible to discover any intelligible principle in the source of the power which the Sultans of Delhi enjoyed for three centuries. देन द स्प्लेंडर ऑफ द सुल्तान्स कोर्ट नंबर 6 पॉइंट आज द सुल्तान्स ऑफ दिल्ली वॉज सीजर एंड पॉप कंबाइंड इन टू वन सो ही यूज टू होल्ड कोर्ट ऑफ और दरबार दिस कोर्ट वॉज नॉन फॉर इट्स स्प्लेंडर एंड जेंडर द पर्टिकुलर गेस्ट वर वेलकम इन द कोर्ट एंड द दरबार वॉज ऑल्सो हेल्ड एट सेलिब्रेट द विक्टोरी ऑन सर्टन फेस्टिवल ऑल्सो द किंग यूज टू कॉल हिज कोर्ट्स द नोबल्स हैड टू ऑब्जर्व सर्टन सेरेमोनियल्स दे हैड टू वेयर ए स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ ड्रेस व्हेन दे यूज टू कम इन द कोर्ट द विजिटर्स वर एक्सपेक्टेड टू कम टू कोर्ट विथ नाजराना और प्रेजेंट एंड देन द नोबल्स व्हाट आर द activity of the nobles in sultanate period bit by bit we will discuss about these things you will listen okay and then I will discuss at the last half an hour during this period the nobles were very powerful they had a great check on the powers of the king sultan could not do anything against the wishes of powerful nobles some of these nobles had a permanent following as they were the heads of clans To impose royal will upon them was a difficult task. These nobles never cared for Sultan as they considered themselves to be equals of the Sultan. Religion was the only thing which held the nobles together. All of them tried to serve Islam in their own humble ways. And the Sultan in the Sultanic period. They were very intelligent. They appointed various type of minister also. Okay, they divided the minister in different parts. And the first upon the wazir, category of the wazir, the functions of the wazir, Diwani-e-Ari, Diwani-e-Insaha, Diwani-e-Rasalat, Diwani-e-Kaja, the other departments controlled by the royal householders. The what were the duties of the minister? The first hala the wazir. Okay, the most important among the minister was the wazir. He was the prime minister and stood midway between the sovereign and his state. He was a partaker. The stability and prosperity of the empire depended upon the wazir. The eminent writer remarks, sovereignty and dominion could not attain the pinnacle of their height without the help and cooperation of a wazir, whose wise deliberation would result in the promoting the welfare of the country and the prosperity of the people. And then category of wazirs. There were two categories of wazirs during the Sultanate period. Most of the wazirs had limited powers, but some of them enjoy unlimited powers. In fact, they were the real rulers and Sultan was only a nominal ruler. And the functions of wazir, in fact, the entire machinery of the government was in his hand. He was particularly the head of the finance department. In this capacity, he had the right to lay down rulers and regulations. Tapre Dewani E. Ari, Dewani Insaha, Dewani E. Riyasat, Dewani Sudar E. Sudar, other department also controlled by the Sultan's period. And then we started the provincial administration of the Delhi Sultanate. Any problem? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Any problem? There are two types of administration in Sultanate period. First upon central administration and then provincial administration. Okay, in central administration, he divided Sultan a despot, Sultan was a law info, and he divided the minister also, the wazir, the category of wazirs, and different department also. And then the other department, other administration of the Sultanate period was the provincial administration. Okay, so we'll read about the provincial administration. Okay, any question or any doubt? Interesting lagun athuwa mu janichi kahi ki na ette jaldi jaldi bhitare sabu ura ko cover kariya ko hela ko gote gote period amku sar padhauthile eto bele amar specialization class hotla aa ekka sari sabu kala ko tike ye hauthwa thik achi to time to paucho sabu note karibo jaha jaha mu kouchi tike bohi ura tike follow karibo mu author ro bohi bi debi plus amar igno ko bi follow karibo hela next hela amar provincial administration okay usha kichi koibo arjit panigrahi
गीता दास मैम सेंट्रल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रे विजार्ड दीवान आई अर्ज ए सब वो ना
दीवानी आरिज देवानी अलसा सुल्तान हाँ से गुड़ा सब अच्छी द
यस सर
वाजीर कैटेगोरी ऑफ वाजीर तापरे हेला जो सुल्तान वाजे लॉ इनटू हिमसेल्फ सुल्तान माने निजे सुल्तान से गॉड भावरे निज को ये करथला प्रथमे से तार निजर प्रतिपत्ति अनुसार जहाँ डिपार्टमेंट नेबा कथा नेउथला मेन हेला फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंटटा तापरे मिनिस्टर मान को भाग करके सब प्रकार डिपार्टमेंट से तांको देइथिला हेला तापरे आसला तार केमती प्रोविंशियल रे कोन कंट्रोल करची शुणिबो कहबि ना प्रोविंशियलटा पड़छि हेला ओके In the beginning, the Sultanate of Delhi was not divided into provinces but into military command known as Iktas. Alauddin Khilij, who conquered the whole country from north to Deccan, allowed big and small provinces to remain in the position as they were found. There were 11 provinces during the reign of Muhammad Tughlaq. The number of these provinces rose to 23. The governors were appointed. Appointed and functions loyalty of the governors are Sahib e Diwan, Sahib e Insaha, appointment and functions of the governors. Each province had a governor whose chief function was to maintain peace and order in province. He had to enforce the royal orders and to lead expedition whenever ordered by the Sultan. He was also required to send the army to Sultan whenever needed. The furnish an account of the an account of the appointment of Governor Hassan Najami has written a famous and servant was chosen to that might look after the soldiers, servants, warriors, and clerks and save them from the treasurers, unbelievers, and designs of the polytheist. He should take plans to fulfill the expectation of the people. He should exercise the greatest circumstances in military and revenue department. He should maintain the tradition, benevolence, charity, so as to leave the name for fraternity. Loyalty of the governors. Generally, the governors were disloyal and faithless. Whenever there was a strong sultan, they were kept under control. But during this reign, the weak rulers, they enjoyed full independence. The sultans like Bolbon, Alauddin, kept them under their control. But during the reign of Muhammad Tughlaq and Firoz Tughlaq, they revolted and declared themselves independent. ମାନେ ଯାହାର ଟିକେ ପାୱାର ଥିଲା ସିଏ କହୁଥିଲା ଆଇ ଆମ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଯେମିତି ଚତୁର୍ଦ୍ଦଶ ଲୁଇ କହୁଥିଲା ସେ କାହାକୁ ମାନୁ ନଥିଲା କିନ୍ତୁ ଯାହାର ପାୱାର ନଥିଲା ସେ ଟିକେ ମାନୁଥିଲା ହେଲା ଦ ବେଙ୍ଗଲ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡେକାନ ୱାର ଦ ପ୍ରୋଭିନ୍ସେସ ହୁ ଅଫନ୍ ରିଭୋଲ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ସ ଦ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ହେଲା ତାପରେ ତ ସାହିଦ ଇ ଦିୱାନି ଭାବରେ ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ଭାଗରେ ସେମାନେ ବିଭକ୍ତ କଲେ ଦେଆର ଅଲସୋ ଏ ପୋଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ସାହିବ ଇ ଦିୱାନ ଇନ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରୋଭିନ୍ସେସ ହି ୱାଜ ଆପଏଣ୍ଟେଡ୍ ବାଇ ଦ ସୁଲତାନ ଅନ୍ ଦ ରେକମେଣ୍ଡେସନ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱାଜିର ଏଣ୍ଡ ୱାଜ ଏ କମ୍ପୋନେଣ୍ଟ ମେନ୍ ଟୁ ଲୁକ୍ ଆଫ୍ଟର ଦ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଟୁ ସବମିଟ୍ ଏ ଡିଟେଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟମେଣ୍ଟ of account to the headquarters was toward his main task. For collection of revenue was their main ambition. There was a Najis and workers also. মানে সবু সিস্টেম রে মানে প্রথমে হচ্ছে ওয়েলথ আর মনি পয়সা সবু সবু জিনিসের দরকার তো সেমানে যেতেবেলে পাওয়ার কো আসতিলে রেভিনিউ কালেকশনটা কো জারি রাখিতিলে কাহা দ্বারা না নাজির আর ওয়াকত মানক দ্বারা তারপরে সেতেবেলে আর গোটে সিস্টেম ছিল সেটা ছিল লোকাল অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেশন লোকালরে বি গোটে অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেশন সেতেবেলে হয়েছিল হ্যাঁ তো ডিউরিং 13 সেঞ্চুরি দেয়ার আজ নো লয়ার ইউনিটি অফ অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেশন দেন ইকটুয়া However, in 14th century, the provinces were divided into sikta, but this system was not adopted in every province. At the head of sikwa, there was a sikadar. His task was to maintain law and order in his jurisdiction. At a later stage, a smaller unit of administration than the sikwa came into existence. It was pragana, which has been identified by Morland with the kuibacha. Ibn Battuta refers that those people give the name of collection of 100 of villagers, Sadi to collection of 100 of villagers. The designation and the duties of officers of Pragana are not definitely known. The Chowdhury and the collector of revenue are also present in every Pragana. And then the last unit of the Sultanate period was that the Panchayat. द लोएस्ट यूनिट वाज द भिलेज व्हिच हैड इट्स ओन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन देयर वाज ए भिलेज पंचायत एंड मोस्ट ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स आर सेटल्ड देयर इन वर्ड्स ऑफ डॉक्टर एल श्रीवास्तवा द पीपल ऑफ द भिलेज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड ए स्मॉल कॉमनवेल्थ एंड लुक्ड आफ्टर देयर अफेयर्स एंड अरेंज फॉर डिफेंस वॉच एंड वर्ल्ड एलिमेंटरी एजुकेशन एंड नॉर्मली दे वर नॉट इंटरफेयर बाय द सुल्तान एवरी विलेज हार्ड देन आज नाउ ए चौकीदारी सिस्टम एंड ए रेवेन्यू ऑफिसर कॉल्ड पटवारी आम गाँ गुड़े जमी सरपंच अच्छा सेमती गोटे पंचायत भी जी थी गाँ गुड़े पंचायत लोएस्ट यूनिट भाव में ग्रहण कराला आउ समस्ते से छोट ईटे हिं टैक्स कलेक्शन करते एजुकेशन ये करते सानिटारी व्यवस्था करते विभिन्न प्रकार डिपार्टमेंट सिटी खंजी देते तो बड़ श्रेणी रू छोट श्रेणी पर्यटन प्रोविन्शियल लोकल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सेंट्रल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन पंचायत श्रेणी सुल्तानेट पीरियड में थिला हला तापरे आसला तुम कौन ना फाइनेंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन फाइनेंशियल क्षेत्र में कौन करते आम जमी फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर मान को डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट दिखाई कि ये ये डिपार्टमेंट रोबे सी से डिपार्टमेंट रोबे सी से पैसा से खर्च करेंगे जमी भी से फाइनेंशियल फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंट रे विभिन्न प्रकार मानने खंजी देते सब मिनिस्टर मान को है तो फिस्काल पॉलिसी ऑफ दिस पीरियड वाज बेस्ड अपॉन द थ्योरी ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड हनीफ स्कूल ऑफ सुनी jurisdiction. The system was borrowed by the Turkish ruler from Ghaznivides. The main source of revenue are sanctioned by the Shariat and Usar. First, Usar. Usar was the tax realized on the lands held by the Muslim. It was 1/10 of the total produce. The whole land was divided into four kinds. प्रथम हैला खालीसा लैंड डिवाइडेड इनटू इक्तवास हेल्ड बाय मुक्तिस फॉर द लाइफ टाइम फॉर शॉर्ट पीरियड टाउन्स एंड विलेज इन हिंदू चीफ्स हु हैड अलाइड देमसेल्फ्स विद द सुल्तान एंड द लैंड गिवन एज गिफ्ट टू द मुस्लिम स्कॉलर एंड सेंट्स द फर्स्ट वन वाज डायरेक्टली एडमिनिस्ट्रेटेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट देयर वाज एन अमीन इन ईच सब डिविजन ही यूज्ड टू कलेक्ट रेवेन्यू टैक्सेस फ्रॉम चौधरी एंड मकदम्स हु टर्न यूज टू रियलाइज इट फ्रम द पिजेंटरी द कलेक्शन अफ रेवेन्यू इन इक्ता वाज इन हैंड्स अफ मुक्तिस हु डिटाच हिज ओन शेयर एंड पेड द रेस्ट अफ गवर्नमेंट द इक्ता लैंड वाज इनाम लैंड एंड फ्री अफ रेवेन्यू आसेसमेंट अलाउद्दीन खिलज मेड इम्पोर्टेंट चेंज इन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन अफ रेवेन्यू ही कन्फिस्केटेड द लैंड हेल्ड बाय मुस्लिम ग्रांटेज एंड रिलीजियस लैंड एंड एंड हिंदू मकदमास एंड चौधरीज वर मेड टू पे टैक्स फ्रॉम व्हिच दे वर फॉर्मली एग्जेम्प्टेड एंड देन खराज द खराज वाज द टैक्स ऑन द हैंड हेल्ड बाय द नॉन मुस्लिम एंड देन जाकत जाकत वाज ए रिलीजियस टैक्स लेविड फ्रॉम द मुस्लिम ओनली इट्स रेट वाज 1/4 2/2% ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी इट वाज चार्ज्ड only if the value of the property exceeded a certain fixed amount of the money collector. The money collector by this tax was spent for certain specific purpose. Jakat could be levied only on that property which was in possession of the owner for at least 1 year. There is also mentioned a separate treasury for Jakat. And then jizya. Jizya was the poll tax changed only for the non-Muslim. Historians are divergent view about the nature of his tax. Some are of the opinion that this was a religious tax levied on the non-Muslim in return for which they received protection of life and property and exemption from the military service as non-Muslims were not entitled to live in Muslim country. However, Dr. Khurasi is of the opinion that these tax levied from a non-Muslim are the cash equivalent of the assistance which they would be liable to give and they had not persist in their unbelief because living as they do in the Muslim state they must be ready for defend it and then the impact of jizya was not secular tax this did not affect the Muslim To call it payment for the privilege of living in Muslim state is also not quite correct because it was not imposed in every Muslim state. However, we can say that it was a forced and illegal tax levied by the Muslim to Hindus It was a very nasty. It is well known that even the vassal of Hindu Raja who rendered military service were not exempted from the payment of jizya. So tell me one question. I will already teach you. Who was the ruler who imposed the jizya tax? Hello? Who was the ruler who imposed the jizya tax?
Ma'am, Humayun?
No, Sushanti. मु बहुत माने भलो कि ताकू पढ़े छी से दिन के को ना देखे हु इज अ ग्रेट लोर
देन आई बाप
नथिंग अरे अकबर अकबर
अकबर हां हां सर
हेलो ओके ठीक अछि तो अकबर होछि कहले कि काहे कि हिंदू मान को ऊपर एमती टैक्स करा जइबो से माने मंदिर फंदिर गला बेले तांको ऊपर काहे कि टैक्स कलेक्शन करा जइबो तो एटा पे से सेटा को माने बंद करथिले एवं जीजीआर टैक्स टा बट माने ता परे कि आसीथिले हम जो आसीले कि कहले औरंगजेब से पुणी आउथरे से टैक्स टा लोक मान को ऊपर लदि देथिले हैला नेक्स्ट हैला हेलो हां लोपामुद्रा बारी किछ कहिबो लोपामुद्रा बारिक
नो मैम
मैम मैम मैम बट गूगल रे दिया है कि अकबर री इंट्रोड्यूस करते थे जीजीआर टैक्स एमटी कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक इम्पोस्ट करते थे सेटा
ना ना से जीजीआर टैक्स टा को उठाई देथले के अकबर
अच्छा
बुझलो एस्टैब्लिश्ड करथिले के कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक बट इम्पोस्ड बाय अकबर कहीं से जिजिया टैक्स कौन पिलग्रिम टैक्स
अण मुसलिम मान टैक्स हिंदू मान देवे
हाँ पा सेटा कौच जो मंदिर फंदिर तीर्थ यात्रा करने को जी से टैक्स टा आदाय कर मुसलिम मान कह तुम से तीर्थ करने को जामको पैसा देक जाओ ए भाया गोटे सिस्टम से ठीक अच्छे एनीवे बट अकबर अकबर अबोलिश द जीजिया टैक्स ओके तापरे एक्सेम्पशन फ्रॉम जीजिया व्हाट एवर हैड बीन द ओरिजिनल इंटेंशन ऑफ लिविंग दिस टैक्सेस बट दिस कैन नॉट बी डिनाइड दैट इट वाज चेंज्ड विगरसली द हिंदू पॉपुलेशन वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री ग्रेड्स फॉर द पेमेंट ऑफ जीजिया सम हिंदूज हैड टू पे इट द रेट ऑफ 48%, सम आर द रेट ऑफ 24% एंड द अदर्स रेट 12%. The tax was not levied on women, children, monks, and beggars. Jizya was not collected from Brahmin also. However, it was also levied from them during the reign of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Since there was a lot of trouble, Hindus of Delhi undertook pay for the Brahmins. And then other sources of income they were collected by the Sultanate period. In their administrative system, there are certain other sources of income which are given: import duties, hairless property, mines and treasures, mineral of taxes, thaprehla najrana and ghanimag. So first upon the import duties on various articles, the import duties were levied. The varied from 2.5% to 5%. From the non-Muslim, it was changed at the double rate of the Muslim. Sikandar Lodi abolished import duties on grains and it was not levied by any subsequent sultan. Taprehla, number two, hairless property. Whenever any landlord died without any hair, hair mane huchi taro bongsaro kei jodi nathibe, mane ta puo ki kehi nathibe. His property was acquired by the state. माने तारो जो दी कही नथिबे माने तारो वंशटा ही वंशटा जो दी तारो लॉस हैला ताले से प्रॉपर्टी टा आसीबो सुल्तान मन को हाथ को हाउएवर द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ हिंदू डिनाइंग इन सिमिलर सर्कमस्टेंसेस हर हैंडेड ओवर टू दिस कमर्शियल तापरे हैला माइंस एंड ट्रेजर व्हेयरएवर ए पर्सन यूज्ड टू एक्वायर मिनरल्स एंड ट्रेजर्स ही हैड टू गिव 1/5 ऑफ द टोटल टू द स्टेट However, if the land did not belong to the finder, the owner of the land was allowed to keep the 1/4 of the treasure and the rest went to the state. And then minor taxes. There was also the house tax, grazing tax, and water tax also. and then Najrana tax. Another important source of income was the Najrana or presents made of the Sultan of the people, officers, nobles, and foreign travelers. In this way, the spoils of war was known as legally out of the booty, and 1/5 was kept by the state, and the rest was to distributed among the soldiers. Later, however, a practice grew up, and 1/5 was distributed among the soldiers, and the rest was kept by the state. It was also legal for the Sultan or head of the army to select an animal, a sword, or some other articles for himself. The name was liked by him. Eti gala tapre asla amro judicial administration of the Sultan period. तो जुडिशियल सिस्टम रे तांकर कोन सब होइतला आज हैड ऑलरेडी बीन पॉइंटेड आउट द सुल्तान वाज द फाउंटेन हेड ऑफ जस्टिस हिज रिस्पांसिबिलिटी वाज टू मेंटेन द कुरानिक लॉ व्हिच वाज ओनली लॉ ऑफ रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय द सुल्तानेट ऑफ दिल्ली सुल्तान वाज द हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जस्टिस एंड यूज्ड टू होल्ड हिज कोर्ट ट्वाइस ए वीक ही हैड बोथ अपीलेट एंड ओरिजिनल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन द केसेस ऑफ हाई नोबल्स वर ऑलवेज डिसाइडेड बाय हिम Sultans like Bourbon and Alauddin Khilij did not hesitate to punish severely to high officers whenever they committed any crime. And then the Chief Sadr and Qazi, Chief Qazi. In deciding the cases, the Sultan was helped by the Chief Sadr and Chief Qazi. The Chief Sadr had to assist him in the religious cases and Chief Qazi is in a secular cases. Appeals from the lower court were also heard by the chief qazi. Provincial and district qazi were also appointed. The chief qazi was assisted by multi. In big cities, there was an omiri that the villagers were their village panchayat to decide the cases. Tapre decision of the cases. Kon decision semane nouthile, hela? The cases were decided according to Quranic law. Even in the cases between Muslim and non-Muslim, the same law was applied. The penal law was very severe. Even for petty offense, they punished the muletarian and death. Bourbon and Alauddin Khilij were more strict in punishing the criminals as compared to their other sultans. And there was no well constituted prisons and no policy in village and small towns. Generally, the old forts were used to prisons. Even the administration of prisons were far from satisfactory. There was too much occupation in the jails. एभली भावरे तांकरो माने जुडिशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन टा थिला एंड द लास्ट एंड द फाइनल सिस्टम ऑफ द सुल्तानेट पीरियड वाज मिलिटरी सिस्टम द सुल्तानेट ऑफ दिल्ली वाज बेस्ड प्रिमिनरी ऑन फोर्स सो मच एम्फसाइज वाज गिवन अपॉन मिलिटरी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द सुल्तान्स वर रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन ए लार्ज आर्मी टू सप्रेस इंटरनल रिवॉल्ट्स एंड द रिपील ऑफ फॉरेन इन्वेजन ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ अली सुल्तान्स The soldiers were supplied by the nobles. Alauddin was the first to take certain effective steps in the administration of army. He kept a big standing army which numbered 4,75,000 horses and he kept a big standing of Tughlaq later and feudal organization and depended upon the supply of jagir. Regular forces employed by the Sultan Troops employed in the service of provincial governors and nobles, soldiers particularly employed at time the war and the Muslim volunteers who entitled themselves as soldiers for jihad. There did not any uniform rule and requirement. Then division of the army. The army consists of cavalry, infantry, and elephants. Most of the effective organ was cavalry. Every horseman had two swords, a dagger, and bow and arrow. Some horsemen carried makaj. The soldier who had one horse were called yakappa, while the soldiers who had two horses were called doapsa. During the reign of Alauddin, yakappa and paid 234 tankas. While the every extra horse soldier was paid 78 tankas. Military officers were paid by assignment of land, revenue, and other troops were paid in cash. Horses were protected with steel sultan also were careful to the sea. Shortage of horse took place for their army. India and Arabia and had a very big trade in horses. Horses were also brought from Turkish and Russia. The poor soldiers were called Paiko. They were very useful and deep keepers and personal guards. They carried bows, arrows and swords. Many of them were slaves and person humble origin. You are the duty of the sultan to inspect the forces regularly. In this way, in sultanate period, the military system, organization of army, payment of taxes, etc. were established. The army of sultans of Delhi was very strong. The organization of discipline system was also looked by the sultan. The division of the army was such that the inter-peace might and external invasion could be checked. In this way, this is the sultanate period was over. Okay, and then the next Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdom. So if any question about the sultanate's administrative system, hello, otherwise I will start Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdom the next unit. Hello,
start. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Consequent upon the break of the Delhi Sultanate, some Hindu princes and Muslim chiefs of the Deccan and South asserted their independence and established their own kingdom. The Hindu founded a kingdom known as the Vijayanagara Empire in South. The Deccan and the Muslim chiefs established a new kingdom known as Bahmani Kingdom in North Deccan. माने हिंदू मानक द्वारा विजयनगर गोटे प्रतिष्ठा होगा आ मुसलिम मानक द्वारा बाहमनी किंगडम स्थापित होगा तो द मुस्लिम चीफ एस्टैब्लिश ए न्यू किंगडम नोन एज द बाहमनी किंगडम इन नॉर्थ डेकन द लेटर हिस्ट्री ऑफ द डेकन इज मार्क बाय द कॉन्स्टेंट स्ट्रगल फॉर सुप्रीमेसी बिटवीन द टू न्यू पावर्स द विजयनगर एम्पायर ओके द विजयनगर एम्पायर एस्टैब्लिश इन 1326 to 1565 AD. The rise of the Vijayanagara Empire was a... Oh, hello.
हाँ मैम लोपामित्रा कौच जो आम विजयनगर किंगडम टा इस्टाब्लिश है साउथ रे वर्तमान रो को को स्टेट को नेकी से उड़ा हितला
विजयनगर टा वर्तमान रो हला आम जेमती की कौच मु कटे कटे रो से कुडा हला विजयनगर बी साउथ रो हला हमरो आबिंदरा आ गोटे हला नेक्स्ट हला हमरो वर्तमान ता ना होची गोटे कोण दिव्यांपला आ साउथ रो जो हमरो जे महा हमरो जो फिल्म टा करची कोण ता ना रो विशाखापट्टनम विशाखापट्टनम आ गोटे विजयवाड़ा तापरे भाईजाक तमरो किछि आइडिया अछि या उपरे विजयनगर एम्पायर जोडा हेइथिला वर्तमान से उडा कोन कोन हेछि कहि परबो कहले देखु
मैम विशाखापट्टनम
तागीवाड़ा विजयवाड़ा एगुड़ा सब सर्दन रे हेतला तागीवाड़ा
मैम कर्नाटक रो किछि पर्सन को कवर करथ लागे
हां कर्नाटक रो किछि साउथ परा
आगे
ओके तो लेट्स स्टार्ट विजयनगर हां
ओके मैम आगे
ओके द राइज ऑफ द विजयनगर एम्पायर वाज वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट इवेंट इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया हैला फॉर 3 सेंचुरीज इट स्टूड एट द बुलवर्क ऑफ हिंदुइज्म एंड सेव्ड द एंशिएंट हिंदू कल्चर एंड रिलीजन फ्रॉम द बीइंग ऑफ समवन बाय द फ्लड ऑफ द मुस्लिम कॉन्क्वेस्ट बिसाइड्स इट एनकरेज आर्ट लिटरेचर प्रमोटेड द वेलफेयर ऑफ द पीपल इट वाज ड्यूरिंग द turmoil of Muhammad bin Tughlaq's reign that the kingdom of Vijayanagara came into existence. The kingdom was established by two brothers, Harihara and Bukka. Harihara and Bukka were the son of Hindu chief Sangma and they were originally the officer of the Kakatiya Warangal and later became the kingdom of Kampil in the modern Karnataka. Karnataka kute jauchi hela. When the Kamapali kingdom was overrun by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, Harihara and Bukka were imprisoned. they were however set for convert to Islam and were the job for peace and order in the realm. Later on, they were the Hinduism are the instance of their guru Bidoyarana. According to another view, Harihara and Bukka were the feudatories of Hoyosala kingdom. Harihara's kingdom in its initial stage included the territories of former Kamopala Hoyosala kingdom. Harihara founded the city of Vijayanagara Vijayawada and made in the capital of his kingdom. The town situated on the southern part or south part bank of the river Tungabhadra river soon developed into flourishing the city. The Vijayanagara Empire is ruled by four dynasties from 1336 to 1614 AD. The Sangama dynasty ruled from 1336 to 1485 AD. The Sulbha dynasty ruled from 1485 to 1505 AD. The Tulbha dynasty ruled from 1505 to 1570 AD. These dynasty were ruled for about a long year. The Vijayanagara and Vijayawada rulers Harihara II, Devaraya II, Krishnadeva Raya played a significant role in the history of Vijayanagara Empire. Okay, so the rise of Vijayanagara Empire brought into conflict with many other powers, the Deccan Fort and the further south. The Sultan of Madurai was its main rival of South India. The struggle for power between two continued for 40 years and it was in AD 1377 that the Muslim kingdom of Madurai was completely wiped out. The Vijayanagara Empire at this stage extended up to Cape Camarin and Kanyakumari and covered the whole of the modern state of Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. In north, the Vijayanagara Empire had to face a powerful enemy in the Bahmani kingdom. The fertile plains of Tungabhadra, Doab between the rivers of Krishna, Tungabhadra, and were the bone of connection between two powers in Maratha country. The struggle between these powers centered around the occupation of Konkan, a narrow strip of land between the Western Ghats and the sea. This reign controlled a port of Goa, which was an important outlet for foreign trade. The military conflicts between the Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdom continued a long, as the two kingdoms remained in existence. A disturbing feature of the war between two kingdoms was that both sides resorted a mass violence, and towns and villages were shaken into burnt ashes. A contemporary historian tells that Bukka destroyed an entire garrison in the Battle of Mudkal in 1367. When the news reached Bahmani Sultan, he was supposed to have taken a vow to take revenge and cross the Krishna River, recaptured Mudkal and fulfilled his vow. Thereafter, he crossed the Tungabhadra and invaded Vijayanagara Empire. Though the ruler of Vijayanagara suffered defeat in the battle, escaped of the war, dragged from the Monsoon together. And the Bahmani Sultan could not neither capture the king nor his capital. Ela, mane Bahmani Vijayanagara bhitare bhi conflict arambha heyaitla. We are told that the battle artillery were used to first time in the history of Indian warfare. Eventually, when both sides were exhausted and they signed treaty of the peace and Doab was divided between two. It was also agreed upon that no side would resort to indiscriminate killing. Kintu tanko bhitare gote mane peace gote create hegala kei ka bhitare au juddha karibani au samaste indiscriminate heke killing ta ko band kariba bole sthira kale ke Vijayanagara au Bahmani kingdom. Though the struggle between Vijayanagara empire and the Bahmani kingdom continued, all through the position of two sides remained more or less the same, with the war swinging someone to side and sometimes to other. Nevertheless, Harihara II wrested Begum and Goa from Bahmani Sultan and assumed the title of Maharajadi Raja. His territory at this stage included the present territory of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and South parts. After the death of Harihara II in 404 AD, Devaraya I succeeded to the throne of Vijayanagara. द डिस्प्यूट ओवर द तुंगभद्रा दोआब अगेन केम इन टू द फोरफ्रंट देयर वाज ए बैटल इन हुईच देवराय फास्ट वाज डिफिटेड बाय द बाहमनी रूलर द किंगडम वाज हाउएवर स्प्रेड देवराय वाज सक्सेडेड बाय हिज सन देवराय सेकेंड ए कंटेम्पररी हिस्टोरियन फरिश्त खान टेल अस दैट द न्यू एम्परर रियलाइज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ बाहमनी सुल्तान ले इन द फैक्ट दे हैड ए हॉर्स गुड गुड आर्चेस द सर्विसेस ऑफ नंबर ऑफ मुस्लिम हॉर्समैन एंड आर्चेस वर देयरफॉर लीव ऑफ जागीर अलॉटेड टू देम फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ गिविंग मिलिटरी ट्रेनिंग टू द हिंदू सोल्जर्स ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ हॉर्सेस वर इम्पोर्टेड फ्रॉम अरबिया देवराय सेकेंड मेड ए रिन्यूअर्ड एफर्ट टू वेज वार अगेंस्ट बाहमनी किंगडम बट बोथ द साइड्स टूक टू देयर पोजिशन एंड रिटेन देयर टेरिटरीज इन दिस वे द पोर्तुगीज राइटर सेड दैट द 16th सेंचुरी वुड बी बिलीव द देवराय सेकेंड हैड कंट्रोल ओवर श्रीलंका बर्मा मालय दिस अपीयर्स टू एग्जरेशन ऑफ देवराय सेकेंड देन कृष्णदेव राय द तुलभ डायनेस्टी दि तुलभ डायनेस्टी रूल्ड बाय कृष्णदेव राय कृष्णदेव राय वाज नॉट ओनली ए ग्रेट जनरल बट एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर ऑल्सो एस्टाब्लिश साउंड सिस्टम ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कृष्णदेव राय एनकरेज इनलैंड एंड ओवरसी ट्रेड व्हिच इनक्रीज द प्रॉस्पेरिटी ऑफ हिज एम्पायर ही ऑल्सो ए ग्रेट पैटर्न ऑफ आर्ट एंड लिटरेचर दो हिमसेल्फ ए बिलीवर ऑफ वैष्णविज्म कृष्णदेव राय रेस्पेक्ट ऑल अदर रिलीजन ऑल्सो ही मेड लार्ज नंबर ऑफ टेम्पल्स एंड स्कॉलर्स एंड ग्रांटेड मैक्सिमम फ्रीडम ऑफ वर्शिप टू हिज सब्जेक्ट एंड देन द बाहमनी किंगडम विजयनगर एम्पायर इन दिस वे दिस चैप्टर ओवर एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट द मुगल एम्पायर एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिस्टम ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर ओके Now the question, any question? Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, any question?
Yes, ma'am.
Pucho. And then the Mughal chapter will, Mughal administrative system will start. Okay. So, pachari bo nole start kariba, hello?
Okay. Ma'am, who establish the Bahamani dynasty or Bahamani empire
Hariharo and Bukka 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 Vijayanagara empire didn't thile Hariharo Bukka di bhai thile tapare conflict hai ki di jana kichi jane huchi upon the break of the Delhi Sultanate re Hindu prisoners Muslim chief thila Deccan ra au di bhai lagile rajya the Vijayanagara re Hariharo Bukka thile हेला बाहमनी किंगडम टा कहली बा तुमको कौन अलग गोटे कृष्णदेव राय ना ना मोहम्मद मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक ओके मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक द बाहमनी किंगडम आर रूल बाय 14 सुल्तान फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग टू 1347 टू 1482 ओके
यस मैम
एट नेक्स्ट माने हासान गांगु बोली गोटे लोकटा एक्चुअली फास्ट आसला तापरे धीरे 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 अन्य माने सब फिरोज शाह बामनी आउ हेला तापरे नेक्स्ट हेला मोहम्मद शाह थर्ड एभली जणे पर जणे आसले हेला नेक्स्ट हेला हमर मोगल मोगल टा पढैबा हेला एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिस्टम ऑफ द बामनी किंगडम टा टिके लेखिबो राइट शॉर्ट नोट्स ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ बामनी किंगडम ओके आउ किछि कहबो हरिहर बुका ताले कोण प्रतिष्ठा करथले विजयनगर एम्पायर हैला
यस मैम
सेटा मु कंफ्यूज हेले आ
दोनों का पहले का जो हरिहर और बुका वो हिंदू थे तो इसलिए वो
हां वो हिंदू थे दोनों
हां वो ये दो ये मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक ये मुस्लिम था और ये
हाँ बाहमनी का नाम मुस्लिम पे जाता है और विजयनगर
हिंदू
हिंदू का जाता है इसलिए देवराय सेकंड देवराय ए वन बाय वन दे माने माने आस दे थ्रोन इन विजयनगर एम्पायर
बट हरिहर का विजयनगर में या बाहमनी
विजयनगर विजयनगर कंफ्यूज हो चुके ए तमरो जो पास रे थिला ना नहीं प्लस टू रे हिस्ट्री थिला ना नहीं ना साइंस सब
साइंस मैम
समस्ते साइंस ओहो
नो मैम
ओ टिके किछि नै
टिके
ओहो धीरे धीरे हे जबो ए जो प्लस 2 बहिरु स्टार्ट करो टिके टिके से विषय रे जानो धीरे धीरे माने हिस्ट्री विषय रे भी जानबो एटा किछि माने बहुत बड़ कथा नै हिस्ट्री टा गप्पो भले पढ़ी नै जबो किन ता भीतर पसिओ पड़िबो हैला तो मोबाइल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन स्टार्ट करबा ना कौन कौन
yes,
हाँ अल्प समय रहा मोगल टा स्टार्ट कर दबा हैला एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिस्टम एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ द मोगल एम्पायर
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम
यस
मैम बी हियर मैम अबाउट प्राइम मिनिस्टर हियर इन भवानी की डंगर मैम अस प्राइम मिनिस्टर मुहूर्त देवा Ma'am, his education, it was quite unique from other king of Bahamani. So can you tell about his administration, how during his time the administration it was unique and it was very strong, that made him as a name or fame in the history of our country, India?
Yeah, it is very important. Did you know about yes. Bahamani and Vijayanagara Empire? Tell me short notes. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you know about yes. know about Bahamani and Vijayanagara Empire? Tell me in short notes.
Yes.
About these two.
Especially Vijayanagara, it was king. Especially it was founded by Harihara and Mukha, and later
yes.
The Krishna River. It was the famous king from that particular dynasty.
Yes.
Who is having to service administration of. It is also very unique because his ministry was quite clever, and
yes.
One many times also we have read many story about him. And the next about is that Bahamani Kingdom it was established by Hasan Gangu, and after him many kings they came. But whenever ma'am for the administration it was we are reading about that Bahamani Kingdom especially. The Prime Minister Hasan that Muhammad Gawar, his administration
yes.
it was unique. It was established by Firoz Shah Bahamani and
yes, very good.
Any
very
other
good.
King, any kingdom. So, ma'am, I want to know especially how he made the that particular administration system quite unique from other kings from that Bahamani kingdom.
Yes, yes, yes. Actually, you are also my teacher because this is माने इग्नो क्लास therefore माने तमे मानकर नॉलेज भी मो पाखरो निश्चिंत भरे भलो थिबो तेनु तमे भी किछि डिस्कशन करबो मो भी किछि त सबुआडु माने एटा जेहेतु हमरो एटा ए क्लास टा माने कोन काउंसलिंग क्लास तेनु बोथ साइड रो हमरो ये रहइबो हैला बुझ पाच वेरी गुड थैंक यू सो मच ओके तो इफ एनी आइडिया अबाउट द मोगल एम्पायर सर टेल मी अबाउट मोगल
एम्पायर
यस हु इज द फाउंडर ऑफ मोगल एम्पायर
बाबर
वाज द फाउंडर ऑफ
मोगल एम्पायर
बाबर वाज द यस टेल मी अबाउट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ मोगल एम्पायर
Especially, overall, madam, the educational system it was different in different particular phase of Mughal rulers. But if we talk
yes.
about in common, the administration it was very good, and especially
yes.
they adopted both Indian Persian style. The administration it was quite good because they merged both the Indian administration and Persian system of administration in our country.
Yes.
India.
Okay.
He is the king. He was all powerful in military, judiciary, and especially regarding the making of law. Also, the king it was all powerful. And during the time, they divided the whole kingdom into different provinces, which was known as Subah during that time. And during that time, the Mughal rulers they appointed Subedar in different Subah. It means for different provinces.
If they collected taxes or not.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
As yes.
Also,
hello. हेलो वॉइस क्लियर नहीं क्लियर हो नहीं टिके ये करके माइक्रोफोन ये करके कौन तू हेलो यस
यस ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम दे अपॉइंटेड 21 आल्सो फॉर द सेफगार्ड ऑफ लॉ एंड द जस्टिस ऑफ द पीपल एंड ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम आई एम स्पेशली इन द रूल ऑफ अकबर अकबर इंट्रोड्यूस मंसबदारी इन हिज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन am I correct ma'am
labauta ma'am now please
हेलो
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 हेलो मैम मैम म्यूट है स्पीकर
हेलो हेलो शर्मिष्ठा
हेलो हेलो
शर्मिष्ठा शर्मिष्ठा टी देखो ना मोर एनरोलमेंट नंबर टा मु पुट करली किंतु मोर एठी इनवैलिड बतौ छी चैट बॉक्स रे मोर अछि तो
देखो छी देखो छी
हेलो एबे आसीला तो एबे आसीला ना मोर हो ताले एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिस्टम टा तमे निजे नोट कर देबो ना पढेबी नहले क्वेश्चन क चलो ये करबा डिस्कशन करबा
मैम
तमो भितरे यस
मैम मोर भी सेम प्रॉब्लम काली पर के मु एनरोलमेंट नंबर पुट करी छी किंतु मोर एठी इनवैलिड बतौ छी एठी जाऊ नी मोर दी थरो टाइप टाइप कर लेनी
सेटा ऑलरेडी तमरो हेई जाय छी ए माने आउ जने जो हमरो सुष्मिता स्वाई से कहले तमरो ऑलरेडी एनरोलमेंट सार को पक्को जाय सच्ची
ओके मैम थैंक यू
आउ जने भी काली बहुत ट्राई करले पसिया पई मुची पसिया पई ये रे जो हमरो क्लास रे किंतु उसे 40 मिनट ट्राई कला परे पसी पालेनी तो बहुत जन काली भी एब्सेंट रहले तो मु भाबुची काली लास्ट क्लास टिके काली टिके अधिका जन रुह ना कोन कहउचो हां तमो
यस मैम
काली लास्ट क्लास टा टिके भलो की माने ये करके सार देबा हो ठीक अछि काली तो अछि काली अछि उचे हमरो कॉलोनियलाइजेशन रो सेकंड पार्ट लैंड रेवेन्यू सिस्टम इन इंडिया ड्यूरिंग ब्रिटिश रूल
ओके
काली के भलो की समस्त पढ़ी देके आस्तिबो एंड देन डिस्कसिंग आल्सो एंड एंड वी माने वी डिस्कस अबाउट दिस थिंग्स हला तो नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट द मुगल एम्पायर और नॉट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ मुगल ओके ओके ओके
हेलो
हेलो
मैम कैसी गले बुलाएंगे
हेलो
हेलो
हाँ हेलो
हाँ गुडी हाँ हाँ गुडी मैं आपण को नंबर टा एथरे मते दे दियो तो मैं इनबॉक्स रे एंटर कर दो जी मु काली उषा कर करी थी उषा झा
हाँ हाँ मोर से ठीक कर दियो प्लीज थैंक यू मोर एनरोलमेंट नंबर अछि 2000 4 2 7 2 7 2 0 7 0 7 ओके हाँ 2 ट्रिपल गुड्डी लिखी दबो 2 ट्रिपल 0 4 2 7 2 0 7
यस
थैंक यू
हेलो सुशांत
यस मैम
जो मैम को नंबर तो ठीक है बट मैम को दे चुकी
शर्मिष्ठा साहू तो हमारा तो एनरोलमेंट अच्छे
ना ना मैम को नंबर तुम दे छ कि किछ व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप ओपन करिया को कहुतली तो तमे भी मैम को जदी नंबर दियन तो हमें गोटे ग्रुप बने परंतु
ठीक अछि मु तो कहुतली मैम को सहित कथा भी हेतली बाकी मु कथा हो छी आज दिस
कहा पाखरे बुक्स आसीले कि
मटेरियल आसीले नि कहा को
कहा को पहुंच छी
नो नो
वो जीरो
427207 सर मैम इज नॉट अवेलेबल
गुडी
हां को
एबे शो कर छी के चैट बॉक्स रे देख लो
हां हां मो देख लबा तमे देई छो एनरोलमेंट नंबर ते थैंक यू सो मच
ओके वेलकम मैम को आडे पड़े गेले
ऑफलाइन हो जेंदी
हेलो हेलो हाँ मैं कौन कहूँ थी लेकिन व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप गुटे कौन नुआ हो चुकी
नुआ तो व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप नहीं आमको जो सर मैंने जो ऐड करी चंदी गुटे इग्नू व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप रे से थी तो मैं ना हो की
हाँ हाँ सही थी रोची आउ ये जो शर्मिष्ठा कोई लेता मैंने उससे नंबर दे चंदी मैडम करो कि वाट तांकू कॉल करबे पई कि सेमती मैडम को किछ कॉल करबे को पड़िबो कि
ना ना जति तो नंबर से कहतली कि हमर किछ ग्रुप कर दे थांते कि प्रॉब्लम किछ होछ जदी असाइनमेंट पास माने कथा हो
हां 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 ठीक कहउछ तो केमती कोन करबो मैडम को फोन करबे
मैम को फोन तो तुम नंबर ता दे दियो कहतु किछ मेंबर आनिया पई आनिले तुम नंबर हम कलेक्ट कर दबो मैम को
ओके ओके हो हो
तो आमे माने समस्त नंबर देबा मैडम को
मैडम तो सेथि लागि
मैडम त समस्ते मैडम को नंबर सेंड कर दियो बाकी
अरे ठीक है सुनो समस्ते मैडम को एनरोल नंबर एनरोलमेंट नंबर ता देबे
नहीं नहीं सब नंबर
एनरोलमेंट नंबर नो हो व्हाट्सएप नंबर
ओके
हां व्हाट्सएप नंबर ते देले से माने हमको गोटे ग्रुप कर देबे हमर जो फर्स्ट ईयर रे जति जण अछि फर्स्ट
ईयर हां हां गुड आईडिया भल हो सब को डिस्कशन करिया को भी हम उठे सुविधा मिल जइबा सब भी इन्फॉर्मेशन अपडेट आमे हे परबा
इन्फॉर्मेशन अपडेट होय तो मटेरियल भी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हे परबो
हेलो
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 हाँ मैम को नंबर अच्छी का पाखे
मैम रो नंबर अच्छी
हाँ
मैम रो नंबर ग्रुप रे अच्छी
हाँ को ग्रुप रे से इग्नो ग्रुप रे नहीं
नहीं ये जोड़ा क्रिएट है जी ना
ये हम तो पर्सनली कहेंगे ना ये प्रॉब्लम हो चुका
890
8903 70 71 ओके मैम थैंक यू मैम
ए कोन मु डिसअपीयर हो जाई थी लिख रे
यस यस मैम
କେମିତି କଣ ନେଟ୍ ଏତେ ସ୍ଲୋ ଆଜି ଚାଲିଛି ତ ବହୁତ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ ହଉଛି କଣ କରିବା ହଉ ଠିକ ଅଛି କେମିତି କିନା ବୋଧେ ଇଏ ଯାଇଥିଲା ଆଉ ଠିକ ଅଛି ମୁଁ ପଢେଇ ଚାଲିଛି ଆଉ ତମେ ଶୁଣୁନ କେତେ ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ଶୁଣିଛ
ନା ମୋଗଲ
ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ ହବ
ଓହୋ ତାପରେ ମୁଁ ଚାରି ଥର ମାନେ ଚାରିଟା ପର୍ସନ ପଢେଇ ସାରିଲିଣି ଆଉ ଭଲ ଠିକ ଅଛି ମାନେ ଆକବର ଏ ମାନେ ସେଇ ସମୟରେ ଆକବର କେମିତି ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେସନ ସିଷ୍ଟମଟା ତାଙ୍କର ଥିଲା ତାପରେ ନିୟୁ ମାନେ ନିୟୁ ତାପରେ 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 କିଏ କିଏ ଥିଲେ ପ୍ରଥମେ ବାବର ହେଲା ତାପରେ ହୁମାୟୁନ ତାପରେ କିଏ କହିଲ ଦେଖ ତାପରେ କିଏ
ଆକବର
ହଁ ତାପରେ
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର
ତାପରେ
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର ପରେ ଶାହାଜାନ
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀରଙ୍କର ଚାରିଟା ପୁଅ ହେଲା ପ୍ରଥମେ ହେଲେ ଆମର କିଏ ବାବର ହେଲା ତାପରେ ହେଲେ କିଏ ବାବର ପରେ ହୁମାୟୁନ ହୁମାୟୁନ ପରେ ଆକବର
ହେଲା
ଆକବର ର ପୁଅ କିଏ ଥିଲେ ଶାହାଜାନ
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର କିଏ ଥିଲେ କୁହ
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର
ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର ଜାହାଙ୍ଗୀର ପରେ କିଏ ଆସିଲେ
ଶାହାଜାନ
ହଁ ଶାହାଜାନ ପରେ
ଶାହାଜାନ ପରେ ଔରଙ୍ଗଜେବ
ଚାରିଟା ପୁଅ ଥିଲେ ତାଙ୍କର ଦାରା ସୁଜା
ଦାରା
ଦାରା ସୁଜା ନୁରା ଔରଙ୍ଗଜେବ ହେଲା ଔରଙ୍ଗଜେବ ହେଲା ତାପରେ ଔରଙ୍ଗଜେବ ଅନ୍ୟ ଭାଇମାନଙ୍କୁ ଇଏ କରିକି ସେ ହଉଛି ସେ ରାଜା ହେଲେ ହେଲା ତ ତାଙ୍କ ସମୟରେ କଣ ଥିଲା ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ ସିଷ୍ଟମଟା ଆଜି ସାରି ଦେଇଥାନ୍ତେ ବଟ ମାନେ ଡ୍ୟୁ ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ନିକାଲ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ ଆଇ ଆମ ନଟ ଆଭେଲେବୁଲ ତ ପଢ଼ଉଛି ନେକ୍ସଟ ହେଲା ଦେଖ ଆଉ 10-15 ମିନିଟ ସାରିଦେବା ଆଉ ନା କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ ଦେଇଦେବି ଲେଖିବ
ଆଜ୍ଞା
କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ ଦେଇଦେଉଛି ଲେଖ ହେଲା ଓକେ ରାଇଟ୍ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ହ୍ୟାଲୋ କିଏ ମାଇକ୍ରୋଫୋନ କିଏ ବନ୍ଦ କର ରେ କିଏ ବୁଝୁଛି ରାଇଟ୍ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଥିଓରି ଅଫ୍ କିଙ୍ଗସିପ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଲାଇଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ନେଚର ଅଫ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ହ୍ୟାଲୋ ପ୍ରଗତି
ଆଜ୍ଞା
ପ୍ରଗତି ମାଇକ୍ରୋଫୋନ ଇଏ କର
ଆଜ୍ଞା
ଓକେ ରାଇଟ୍ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ଦ in the light of the nature of the state write about the theory of kingship in the light of the nature of the state next hala discuss about the administrative system of sultanate period discuss about the administrative system of sultanate period discuss about the administrative system of sultanate period write an essay on the theory and governance of Delhi Sultanate and write about the administrative system of Mughal period write about the administrative system of Mughal period ସୁଲତାନେଟ ମାନଙ୍କର ଯୋଉ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେସନ ସିଷ୍ଟମଟା ଥିଲା ମୁଁ ସର୍ଟଲି ଆଉ ଥରେ କହିଦେଉଛି ହେଲା ରାଇଟ୍ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ ସିଷ୍ଟମ ଅଫ୍ ସୁଲତାନେଟ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ସେଟାକୁ ଲେଖିଦିଅ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନଟା ତାପରେ ମୁଁ ସର୍ଟଲି ତମକୁ ପୁରା ସର୍ଟ କରିକି ପଢି ଦେଉଛି ସର୍ଟ କରିକି ମାନେ ବୁଝେଇ ଦେଉଛି ହେଲା ପୁରା ସର୍ଟଲି ଶୁଣ ହଁ ଶୁଣିବ ନା administrative system of sultanate period
yes ma'am
okay suno ha the nature of the state promoted the sultans of delhi to design a various administration of the people no doubt islam was a potent factor of the government of the state however some sultans gave good administration तो फास्ट है सेंट्रल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन द खलीफा वाज द हेड ऑफ द एंटायर मुस्लिम वर्ल्ड द सुल्तान ऑफ दिल्ली रिसीव्ड दिस ब्लेसिंग ड्यूरिंग कोरोनेशन हाउएवर सुल्तान्स लाइक अलाउद्दीन खिलज मोहम्मद बिन तगलक डिड नॉट एस्पेक्ट द सुप्रीमेसी ऑफ द खलीफा द सुल्तान वाज द हेड ऑफ द सुल्तानेट पीरियड ही बिलीव्ड इन द डिवाइन थ्योरी ऑफ किंगशिप एंड कंसीडर्ड हिमसेल्फ एज जिल इल्लाहा द शैडो ऑफ गॉड एमंग द वजीर was the prime minister of Diwani Rasalot was the foreign minister in royal correspondence Borid e Mamalik looked after the secret policy and intelligence Quajat was the looking after the judicial department of Diwani Mamalik and then the Bakil e Dar was in charge of the royal family the regulator body of the guards of sultan was Amir e Khoha the minister of agriculture and the minister in charge of hunting was Amir e Shikar Amir e Imarat was the minister of agriculture and other department the sultan of delhi put emphasis on military administration Alauddin Khilj introduced descriptive law system and sign of the dag system he was the highest officer in cavalry shahan e pahi was the head of the elephant force the head of the soldier was military officer was alauddin khilj has started market regulation policy jihad and grow and was brought to subdue the hindus several taxes collected were zakat खामोस खाराज एंड उसार अलाउद्दीन खिलज कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम हिंदूज ए हेटेड टैक्स नेम्ड जिजिया द पुअर मुस्लिम्स वर गिवन रेंट फ्री एंड व्हिच वाज नोन एज मादाद ई माहिज एंड द लुक्ड आफ्टर द पुलिस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड इन चार्ज ऑफ पोस्टल डिपार्टमेंट दस द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ड्यूरिंग द सुल्तानेट पीरियड वाज क्वाइट एफिशिएंट एंड देन वी स्टार्टेड प्रोविंशियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ओके provincial administration be mu shortly I will tell shortly the sultan paid attention to the provincial administration the provincial rulers were named mukti wali naib sultan they were given iktas by the sultan ikta was a portion of the empire which was ruled by the ruler during alauddin khilj there are two types of ikta the first of ikta was given to provincial ruler of the basis of hereditary succession the second type of ikta was created by taking together the conquered lands there are some provincial rulers who are independent in the internal administration but they accepted the suzerainty of the sultanate of delhi the provincial rulers enjoyed all the powers what the sultan in center they also maintained the army like the sultan though the army he maintained the discipline his area so a part of the revenue collected from the province was given to the provincial ruler The collection of revenue and expenditure of the province was checked by an officer named Diwani Wazir. When a sultan became weak, the provincial ruler declared independence. Of course, the sultan like Bulbon Alauddin Khilj collected news about the provincial rulers and awarded the punishment who were defiant against him. ये तार रूल टा को भांगिला ताको पनिश करथले एंड देन लोकल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इन शॉर्टली ईच प्रोविंस वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू सेवरल सिक्वा एंड सिकादर वाज अपॉइंटेड लुक आफ्टर इट्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ईच सिक्वा वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू प्रगणा हुज चार्ज वाज वेस्टेड विथ एन अमिल ही लुक्ड आफ्टर द जनरल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड रेवेन्यू कलेक्शन इबन बतुता द फॉरेन ट्रैवलर हु विजिटेड इंडिया ड्यूरिंग द टाइम मोहम्मद बिन तगलक डिस्क्राइब foreign traveler mohammed bin describes that a pragana consists of 1000 village in the province khojedar was in charge of royal treasury qazi was looked after judicial administration and chaudhuri looked after the peasants the lowest units of administration during sultanate was village the village headman and other panchayat which looked after the problems of the village like education cleanliness crimes etc the potwari collected revenue from village and chowkidari collected crime chowkidari controlled crimes in fact the central administration during the sultanate was very strong The provincial administration was also very efficient, and so also the local administration crimes were checked and peace prevailed throughout the country. In this way, the sultanate in the sultanate period, the society also divided into many categories. The long 300 years of Delhi Sultanate before many changes during this period. The Islam was felt on Indian society. The Hindu and Muslim were two sides of the same coin. Here is an analysis of the society in the administrative system of the of Delhi Sultanate. Class division. There was a class division in both Hindu and Muslim society. The caste system existed in Hindu society. There are four castes among the Hindus like Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. It is ultimately in all tribes. There are many sub castes among the Hindus and even such as Chandala and lived in the society. The nobles of Muslim society were called Umar. They were designated as Khan, Malik and Malik Kapoor, Sariji, Khalsa, etc. The intellectuals were known as Ulema, and people belonging to this class were known as Qazi-e-Kujawat, Sadar-e-Sadar, Qazi and Muspi. Below the nobles remained the middle class like the merchant, Mokdam and others. The lowest category of the society remained the common men like the peasants, the workers, the artisans, the soldiers, and etc. They were known as Aman-e-Khalak. The Muslim names are so many names, very difficult. Position of the men.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, jemiti amara Hindu manankara Brahmin, Kshatriya, Shudra, Vaishya, tara last eta rala Chandala. Semiti Muslim manankara category ta tike kahibe ki?
ତାଙ୍କ କ୍ୟାଟେଗୋରି ତ ମୁଁ ପୁରା ଜାଣିନି ବଟ୍ ତାଙ୍କର ବି ମାନେ ସମ୍ପ୍ରଦାୟ ଅଛି ଦୁଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ହେଲା ସିହା ଆଉ ସୁନି ହେଲା ତ ସିହା ସମ୍ପ୍ରଦାୟ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ସୁନି ମାନେ ଦେଖ ଏଠି କାଷ୍ଟ ସିଷ୍ଟମ ଆସିଲେ ମୋତେ ମାନେ ଠିକ ଲାଗୁନି ବଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଆୱାର ବୁକ୍ ଓକେ ସିହା ହଉଛି ଟିକେ ବଡ଼ ଆଉ ସୁନି ମାନେ ହଉଛନ୍ତି ସାନ ହେଲା ୟେସ୍
ହେଲୋ ମ୍ୟାମ୍
ୟେସ୍
ମୁସଲିମ୍ସ ଆଲସୋ ୱି ହାଭ ଆଲସୋ 3 অর 4 ଟାଇପ୍ସ ଅଫ କ୍ୟାଟେଗୋରିଜ୍
ଓହୋ ओके ओके एम डी जाके टेल मी अबाउट सॉरी 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 आई एम सो सॉरी टेल मी अबाउट आई एम नॉट अबाउट दिस रिलीजन ओके ऑल आर इक्वल देयरफॉर यू टेल मी अबाउट दिस आई नो अबाउट दिस थिंग्स ओके टेल 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 माय स्टूडेंट एम डी जाकिर टेल मी अबाउट दिस थिंग्स
एक्चुअली तो आमो भीतर भी जंती जंती हिंदू मानन भीतर अछि ब्राह्मण जंती सब फर्स्ट अछि ऊपर का
किछि हिंदू मुस्लिम नै रे समस्त एका खाली कुहो कि तम हां
ତାଙ୍କୁ ଅଧିକ ଉପର ମାନେ ଇଏ ଦିଆହେଇଛି ସେମିତି ଟାଇପ୍ ସବୁ ଯେମିତି ବ୍ରାହ୍ମଣ ପୂଜା କରିପାରିବେ ତ ସେମିତି ଏମାନଙ୍କୁ ବି ଆମ ମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଅଛି କି ଏମାନେ
ପରଦା ପ୍ରଥା ଦ କମନ୍ ହିନ୍ଦୁ ଓମେନ୍ ହେଲ୍ପ ଦେୟାର ହଜବେଣ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫ୍ୟାମିଲି ମେମ୍ବର୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚର ଡିଡ୍ ନଟ୍ ୟୁଜ୍ ଭେଲ୍ ଦ ଓମେନ୍ ଏଜୁକେସନ୍ ଗ୍ରେଟ୍ ଏକ୍ସଟେଣ୍ଟ ଦ ରାଜପୁତ ଓମେନ୍ ରଷ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଜୋହାର ବ୍ରତ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡାଇନ୍ ଫ୍ୟୁନେରାଲ ଅଫ୍ ଫାୟାର ଅଫ୍ ହର ହଜବେଣ୍ଡ ଦ ମୁସଲିମ ଲେଡିଜ୍ ୱେର୍ बुर्खा सिस्टम एज पर द लॉ ऑफ कुरान एंड अल्लाह वन मैन कुड मैरी फोर वोमेन बिसाइड्स द वोमेन ऑफ द नोबल्स अदर मुस्लिम वोमेन आर डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन वन मुस्लिम मैन कैन डिवोर्स हिज वाइफ बाय अटरिंग तलाक थ्री टाइम्स बट नाउ इट बी अबोलिश्ड द कॉमन वोमेन आर कुकिंग फूड फॉर फैमिली स्टिचिंग क्लोथेस एंड डूइंग अदर नीडल वर्क्स देयर फूड्स ऑल्सो द हिंदू खिचड़ी ब्रेकफास्ट बट द मुस्लिम रोटी कबाब एटसेट्रा ड्रेस ऑर्नामेंट्स ऑल्सो हिंदू फैमिली कॉस्टली ड्रेस एंड द मुस्लिम नोबल ऑल्सो वेरी कॉस्टली ड्रेस एंड रिक्रिएशन ऑफ द मुस्लिम ऑल्सो रेसोटिंग बॉक्सिंग प्रेसिंग देयर लीजर दे आर प्लेइंग चेस चौघाटा एंड एटसेट्रा वेराइटीज ऑफ दे ऑल्सो एंजॉय वेराइटीज ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स दोज आर द मोहरम ईद ई मिराज ईद उल फितर ईद ई जोहा दे ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व नावरोज बदवा फतवा रबी उल अलवा एंड आखिर चौहार संभा इन केस ऑफ एजुकेशन द मुस्लिम सोसाइटी एजुकेटेड ऑल्सो द मुस्लिम सोसाइटी एजुकेशन वॉज इम्पार्टेड इन अरबिक एंड पर्शियन लैंग्वेज सुल्तान टूक स्टेप फॉर द स्प्रेड ऑफ एजुकेशन एमंग द मुस्लिम ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ फिरोज शाह तगलक देर आर 30 मद्रास इन कंट्री इन प्रोविंशियल सिस्टम ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लाइक द लेवल ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम इन इक्विलिब्रियम सिस्टम अबोलिश्ड इन प्रोविंशियल लेवल इब्राहिम द रूलर ऑफ जौनपुर टूक स्टेप्स फॉर द स्प्रेड ऑफ साइंस एंड एजुकेशन सो फरिश्ता द हिस्टोरियंस ऑफ दैट टाइम गेव हिम द टाइटल ऑफ सीजर ऑफ इंडिया द स्लेवरी सिस्टम ऑल्सो एट दैट टाइम An ugly feature of the Muslim society was the slavery system. The Sultan nobles and rich Muslim kept slaves. The slaves had no freedom. They observed the order of their master. Even they were ready to sacrifice their life for their master. They are very faithful. The Sultan Iltutmish and Bulban were slaves in due course of time. This system entered into the Hindu society. However, this slavery system of Muslim was not liked by the Hindu society. Thus, the society during the Sultanate period a stamp of time. But now there are some author and there are modernized all the people and they are all are equal. The Hindu society was highly balanced. They became very rigid to save their society. And they retain their spectacular education, fairs and festival. And both in Hindu and Muslim were friends. And the Hindu are observed Muslim festivals. And the Muslims are observed also Hindu festival. Okay. Any questions? Hello?
No, ma'am.
Hey, tomorrow got a group kari diyo. Hello, Sarmishtha, Gudi, Pragati, Pushpanjali, Usha, got a group kari diyo, taki tomman ko subidha hava. Dhara jane no asi palla, jane no posi palla, to taku not ki question, taku jemti ki share kari paribo. Thik achi? Hello?
Okay,
Sushanti?
Yes, ma'am.
Tomman ko bhitare kemti number ta ye kari paribo. नले मो व्हाट्सएप रे समस्त नंबर पठा मो जॉन को दे देबे से तारो शेयर करके ये करनबो आ क्वेश्चन डिस्कशन कोन हैला केते बेले परीक्षा होबो कोन होबो इट इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी
यस
मैम सर सब बेले मेसेज तो छाडू छंती माने धरो नेटवर्क किछि हैला कि कोन हैला धरो कोन गोटे माने प्रॉब्लम हैला तो तुमो भितरे माने सेटा शेयर करि पारिबो
डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होइ पारिबो
हां डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होइ पारिबो सुशांति तुम नंबर सब सब मान मोर तो नहीं जाइ अर्जित अक्षय सेठी अक्षय अर्जित हेलो
यस
मैम हाँ सब नंबर करके तुम मान भीतर जो क्वेश्चन जहाला डिस्कशन हला सब ये करबो ठीक अछि आ कोन कहबो ना पळेबा ओके गुड बाय एंड गुड डे ओके नेक्स्ट क्लास हैला ओके ओके
थैंक यू
मैम बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर नेक्स्ट बिकॉज़ दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट
थैंक यू
ओके गुड डे ओके
थैंक यू मैम
थैंक यू मैम
थैंक यू स्टूडेंट
हैव अ नाइस डे मैम
ओके बाय Thank you.
हेलो